few years back, I got a phone call from a lawyer in Gwinnett County, Georgia, who had been trying to find a home for a case that he really felt passionate about. Deep down in his heart, he knew that something went wrong and that there needed to be something done about it. And he had sent the case to several firms before he called me. They all told him there's nothing that can be done. And I just got that case and I could hear it in his voice that there was something about this case that I needed to look deeper into, and I did. And so I began the process of learning about this case, digging into it and finding out all that you have to know to litigate a case against a major automotive manufacturer. We first learned that our client was she was taking her daughter to work at a job. She was 15 years old. The daughter had a permit, hadn't yet got her license yet, and they're leaving the house that day, and the daughter asked her mom, said, "Can I drive?" And, you know, she wants her daughter to learn how to drive her car. She says, "Sure, you can drive." And so she gets in the passenger seat, and the daughter drives the car. On the way to work that day, the road wasn't busy. It was a sunny day. For some unknown reason, the car lost control. She rolls over, and despite the fact that the mom in the passenger seat was correctly wearing her seatbelt, she's thrown from the vehicle. The daughter, who was also correctly wearing her seatbelt, was fine. She was in the driver's seat. She stayed in the car. She barely got hurt. And a little boy that was following him, he was 16, had his driver's license, and had been in the car behind him. Didn't know the family, just happened to be there. Comes up and really is scared to death himself. He's seen this tragic wreck. The car rolled over 4 times. And he goes first to look in the car and sees that the daughter's okay. And then the daughter's like, "Where's my mom?" And there's no mom in the car. So he runs down the street where she's thrown from the vehicle. And he walks up to this mom who's laying now in the roadway. And she kept saying over and over again, "But I was wearing my seatbelt. But I was wearing my seatbelt." Over and over and over. And it just stood out in that little boy's mind. And he said, "In my mind, she couldn't figure out why she was laying in the road when she was wearing her seatbelt." When I heard that boy, what he told me, I had to find out why she was laying in the road and she was wearing her seatbelt, because that should never happen. We got into the case. We found out that the decision was made by the automotive manufacturer to use a cheap seatbelt in the passenger seat. They could have put a more expensive, safer seatbelt with an extra safety device that prevented the seatbelt from becoming unlocked during the wreck, but they instead chose that since it was in the passenger seat, and that most people only drive with a driver in the car and nobody in the passenger seat, that the chances were that in a wreck, that the car wouldn't have anybody sitting there. So why put an expensive seatbelt in that? Instead, they put a different, safer seatbelt in the driver's seat. That's why the daughter was not hurt, wasn't thrown from the vehicle. The mom sat there in that car not knowing that she had a dangerous, unsafe seatbelt that was designed to protect her. It didn't do the one thing it was made to do. That seatbelt's entire existence on this earth was designed for that one time that it should have held that lady in the car, but it didn't. We took that case to trial, and a jury in Gwinnett County found for the family. They said that that seatbelt was not designed safely and that there were safer alternatives that should and could have been used, and rendered a verdict finding the seatbelt manufacturer responsible for that seatbelt. And this is why I became a lawyer. Because that little girl, that 15-year-old girl, she had grown up. She had gone to college by the time we got to trial. And when we got, she had never quit blaming herself for her mama's death. She was driving. It was a single vehicle accident. She said, "If I had kept that car in the roadway, it would have never rolled over." When that jury came back and put all the fault on the car company, when that jury came back and said the car company is at fault for what happened, She called and told me, she said, I always blame myself, but now I know that it was a seatbelt fault. It was a seatbelt fault, and that was why we do this. It was why we do this. It wasn't about the money that we got. It wasn't about, it was about making cars safer. They don't use that seatbelt anymore. It's about letting that little girl know that, hey, it wasn't your fault that your mom died. If that company would have done its job, if that company would have put just the same seatbelt that you were wearing that day in the passenger seat, she would have got banged up. She would have got some cuts and some scrapes maybe, but she would have been your mama. And she would have been around to watch you graduate from high school, and she would have been there to watch you go to college, and she would have helped you move in the dorm. But she missed every bit of that because a car company decided to save money and put a cheaper seatbelt, taking a chance that nobody would be sitting there when their car rolled over. It's an easy call why I represent people like that. Why else would you need a reason to help people other than that?